selection committee pays close attention to these games.
There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
I'll tell you one thing. How they start the game is very important and will sometimes dictate how the game is played.
Lots of opportunities. If you give help on that cutter, the screener steps back. It's usually wide open for an open jump.
He strokes it. Perfectly executed. He can put points up and he can move the ball.
When you combine those two skills, the floor looks a lot wider for everyone on your team.
The Eagles have been completely silenced by the losing streak that they're on. Desperate for a win, wouldn't you say that?
I know for a fact that their coaches are working them day and night. So expect to see an exciting, high-energy ball game today. They need a solid effort from everyone on their team. You know, seniors are a dying breed in college basketball these days. If you're a coach that's lucky enough to have a couple, it can definitely help you sleep at night knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful. Let's go back on our campus as PMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
They got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brian.
Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Did the guy in the stands call for it? Here's the inbound play on the baseline.
Important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
On the outside, he fires it up. In and out. Looking for a good shot. In the lane. Nails the jumper. Circle, they work it around the perimeter. He buries the jumper. The crowd begins to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. With Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us.
It's well-executed two-man game. It's always a treat to watch.
Off the glass and no good. Gave it up.
Nobody getting back, Brad. Where's the defense?
For two. Sinks the shot. He can light things up in a hurry. He's got that scorer's mentality.
He's one of those guys who's really a gifted scorer. He can really put up some great, great numbers.
Woodruff handles the pass. Goes up.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Brewer handles the pass. Takes the jumper. He drains the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. It sticks.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
With the J. And come up short. They work the perimeter. Brewer picks up the foul. Here's another solid junior.
You know, by the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's a matter of bringing it every day.
First shot is no good.
Coaching staff wants their team.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with a blocked shot. And the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
On the left side. Bend the low block. Puts up the jumper.
Figures of multiple statistical categories, you're a lucky guy.
Second shot is no good. Pushes it up.
Defensively.
Too physical. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time.
Concentration, you gotta concentrate.
Way
Brick
short.
City.
It's the second. They've got him right where they want him, Dick. trouble here. Mott receives the pass. Tries for two. He couldn't get it to fall. In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
I think when you have balance inside, outside, scoring, tempo control, where you control the pace of the game, and that's what they try to do with their balance. They'll go fast, they'll go slow. They try to dictate tempo.
Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Can't connect. Pushes it up. Puts it up. Doesn't go. Bowen handles the feed. Cross court. Let's watch the move as he works his man. Fadeaway jumper. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
They look to get it to the inside. Three. He misses the fadeaway. Looking for a good shot. For two. These rims are giving them trouble, Dick. They can't get anything to drop.
Wow, when a team is shooting the ball like this, I'm telling you, they're not focused. They're going to drive the coach bananas. Practice is going to be so tough tomorrow. I mean, they need repetition, repetition, repetition. And it's nothing but one brick after another.
The perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He tries the jumper. Woodruff handles the feed. Trying to feed inside with the jumper. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Jumper, missed the jumper. Woodruff receives the pass. He goes up with it. Busts the J. Up the J. They're not doing a very good job of finding the hoop tonight, Dick.
Well, they're not working the ball around. They're not finding the open man.
Bowen receives the pass. Trying to feed the low block. Puts up the J. Knocks it down. Way out of, he blocks the shot. Working it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots kill chemistry, Brad.
On the elbow, they beat that on the low block. Missed it. Bowen handles the feed. Trying to pack it inside. He shoots the jumper. The missed shot. The Eagles prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times, and then really settling in the half court at other times.
Definitely, Brad. They prefer a more balanced style, picking and choosing when to force the tempo and when to settle down in the half court.
Such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Ware isn't the greatest free throw shooter.
He just needs to focus on the rim. Mr. Nessler, they like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
The Eagles have been getting it done tonight in a lot of different ways.
Everyone is getting a foul, and everyone is having a good time. The great thing about basketball is you don't always have to score to be a threat. Teamwork can help you win a lot of games.
Bowen receives the pass. Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
And it's knocked loose. Around 8 minutes remaining. Into their zone motion now. Entry pass in the paint. Off the glass and no good. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You better get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
Bowen is fired up right now emotionally.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you should be afraid to show your emotions.
He shoots from the corner. Jumper won't go. Bowen handles the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
We're at the 7 minute mark. Ware handles the pass. Six-minute mark.
See what they come up with, Brad. good spacing. That's so important with a good offensive set. It's even more important on college guards like
that. Yeah, that helps. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
On the outside, puts up the jumper. Off the mark. There's such a variety of team styles these days, Dick. What are some of the qualities for a half-court team?
When they do those types of things, Brad, they get into a rhythm. Everyone knows that rhythm is crucial for offensive success in basketball or for any sport for that matter. That's definitely a correlation.
They work it around the perimeter. Let's watch the move as he works his man. Fadeaway jumper.
Up and inside.
Goes up with it. Off the mark. Rebounds it.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
Receives the pass. We're at the 4 minute mark. They're working around the arc. Puts it on the floor and up and under. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. Inside, puts it on the floor and up and under. Nope. Takes the board.
Then I've got to get out and pull the lanes, Brad.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
Brad, he's got that first-year of experience under his belt. So this season, his team is going to be looking for him a lot more.
Gets the first shot. Second one, no good. Harden handles the pass.
Something positive to happen, which will light his fire and get him going.
Anderson handles the pass. He attempts a jump shot. Can't connect. We're at the 2 minute mark. Inside. To shoot. Plus the jumper. shoots from outside. Missed the jumper. Woodruff receives the pass. On the game clock, in the paint, goes up for two. He nails the bucket. Got it down the low block. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. It in. We'll stay right here. And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
Wow, he's really elevated his game. A big-time player, scoring the basketball and doing it all. Just a special player. You know, he's great to watch.
Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Nine on the shot clock. The center receives the pass. They just can't find the open seams on the floor.
They're struggling to score right now.
Douglas receives the pass. Trying to beat the buzzer.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
shot, Brad.
Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
That's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Anderson goes to the line for the first time. Well, the arc looked good. These kids are really struggling from the free throw line tonight.
I hope they can turn it around before it costs them the game.
Tries for two. That's good.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
Now trying to feed the low block. He tries the jumper. I just can't seem to get a nice look at the goal tonight.
They have to be patient on offense and find some easy hoops.
He shoots from the deep corner. Nails the jumper. On the outside. He goes up with it. And come up short. Looking for a good shot. Jumper. Jumper won't go. Makes it.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
Looking to move it around the perimeter.
Repetition, 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 and it's nothing but one brick after another.
Goes up for two. They're getting no good looks at the hoop tonight, Dick.
I don't know what they're doing, but it's wandering away. All those easy looks underneath. Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Turnaround jumper.
I'll tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, getting in the way, passing the block.
They work the perimeter. Here comes the ball screen. Brewer receives the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Terrific shooting continues.
Hey, when you get in a funk like this, you've got to get a few gimmies, some layups, something that's going to get your rhythm back and give you the confidence to shoot from the perimeter.
For two, you betcha.
certain that you guys saw all that excitement from the bench. It'll be interesting to see how the coach's enthusiasm rubs off on the players. Will they be able to take their play to another level and keep their momentum on their side? I guess time will tell, Brad.
Well, nobody said it was going to be easy, but they did coaching, that is.
I sure hope not. A lot of sleepless nights coaching a basketball team. The expectation to win consistently, not win occasionally, but to win consistently. Winning consistently is one that stresses out a lot of coaching.
Especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you've got to give help on him and a leap.
And a shot block. Three-point shooter spotting up. He shoots the jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Trouble here. pushes it out. There's the pick. There's the roll. Working it around the perimeter. Shoots from the corner. Off the mark. Woodruff receives the pass. He attempts the jump shot. Knocks it down. When you notice a slasher, the defense has to be ready for your drive.
I tell you, he really has natural ability. Uses that athleticism to break down the defense. Really effective off the dribble.
The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
They're lucky right now, my goodness.
Tries for two. Nope. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Cross court. His jumper. They got it. He pulls up, baskets good, and he got a little charity for his effort.
Hey, he did a good job of keeping himself under control despite the foul.
Basketball.
They make it really tough for the opposition. If they can't keep this up, They'll all be happy once the final buzzer set.
They'll throw this one in from the side. Receives the ball. They go into the low block. Ball down low. Puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. Brewer receives the ball. On the outside. For two. He gets the bucket. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, you know, great post play, you got a chance to really win.
Well, the bucket goes in. Good cut, great pass right there.
Brad, those are the type of reads you look for in practice.
Cross court. Count that as a personal foul. Well, I don't know if their second thing is a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created the foul opportunity.
It's two with the cherry strike. Oh, this man's in trouble. Strips the ball. Looks like he put the ball right in his hand.
Hey, he'll be thinking about that one all night.
Such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Chance to get an easy one here. Makes it. Shot. Brewer receives the ball. Goes up for two. Gets it to fall. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. They're working around the perimeter. For two, off the backboard. Now looking for the ball screen, Dick.
Hey, a two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporated into their scheme because it works.
With the fadeaway jumper, look at that follow-through.
I tell you, great footwork, too, to create that opportunity. And then he's got the touch. What an offensive play.
Decision to take that shot there.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there. Up and inside!
4 minutes left on the game clock. He shoots the jumper. It come up short.
Second effort to stay with him right there. Did a great job attacking the defense.
receives the ball. The man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Gave it up.
To take away his driving angle.
1 minute left on the game clock. Had a momentary look from three-point land for three. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Moving it around the perimeter. From the corner. And he's no good from downtown. Ware receives the ball. On the outside. Launches away. The missed shot. Shot clock is dead.
Yeah, they can't seem to find their stroke yet, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. The Hawks finally break that ugly stretch of losing that they've been on.
Hey, it's always tough to come into a game riding a losing streak, but they no longer have to worry about that. Now they must continue to do the things which put them in position to win this game. Spacing, that's so important in a good offensive set. it's even more important how talented guards like they are.
Yeah, that helps. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
On the outside. Puts up the jumper. Off the mark. There's such a variety of team styles these days, Dick. What are some of the qualities for a half-court team?
When they do those types of things, Brad, they get into a rhythm. Everyone knows that rhythm is crucial for offensive success in basketball or for any sport for that matter. That's definitely a correlation.
They work it around the perimeter. Let's watch the move as he works his man. Fadeaway jumper.
Up and inside.
Goes up with it. Off the mark. Rebounds it.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
Receives the pass. We're at the 4-minute mark. They're working around the arc. Puts it on the floor and up and under. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. Inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Nope. Takes the board.
Then I've got to get out and pull the lanes, Brad.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
Brad, he's got that first year of experience under his belt. So this season, his team is going to be looking for him a lot more.
Gets the first shot. Second one, no good. Harden handles the pass.
Something positive to happen, which will light his fire and get him going.
Anderson handles the pass. He attempts the jump shot. Can't connect. We're at the 2-minute mark. Inside. To shoot. Plus the jumper. Yeah. shoots from outside. Missed a jumper. Woodruff receives the pass. On the game clock, in the paint, goes up for two. He nails the bucket. Got it down the low block. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. It in. We'll stay right here. And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
Wow, he's really elevated his game. A big-time player, scoring the basketball, doing it all. Just a special player. You know, he's great to watch. Start the game is very important and will sometimes dictate how the game is played. Lots of opportunities. If you give help on that cutter, the screener steps back. It's usually wide open for an open jumper.
He strokes it. Perfectly executed. He can put points up and he can move the ball.
When you combine those two skills, the floor looks a lot wider for everyone on your team.
The Eagles have been completely silenced by the losing streak that they're on. Desperate for a win, wouldn't you say that?
I know for a fact that their coaches will work on them day and night. So expect to see an exciting, high-energy ball game today. They need a solid effort from everyone on that team. You know, seniors are a dying breed in college basketball these days. If you're a coach that's lucky enough to have a couple, it can definitely help you sleep at night knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful. Let's go back on that campus as PMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
They got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brian.
Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Did the guy in the stands call for it? Here's the inbound play on the baseline.
Important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
On the outside, he fires it up. In and out. Looking for a good shot. In the lane. Nails the jumper. Circle, they work it around the perimeter. He buries the jumper. The crowd begins to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
And our trifecta. active through the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us.
Up in the Wall of Fame with well-executed Julian Davis, always a treat to watch.
Off the glass and no good. Gave it up.
Nobody getting back, Brad. Where's the defense?
For two. Sinks the shot. He can light things up in a hurry. He's got that scorer's mentality.
He's one of those guys who's really a gifted scorer. He can really put up some great, great numbers.
Woodruff handles the pass. Goes up.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Brewer handles the pass. Takes the jumper. He drains the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. With a bucket, it sticks.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
With the J. Short. They work the perimeter. Brewer picks up the foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior.
You know, by the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's a matter of bringing it every day.
First shot is no good.
Coaching staff wants their team
and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with a blocked shot. And the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
On the left side. Bend the low block. Puts up the jumper. Obvious foul. Well, he commits an intent. empty basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
There's a snapshot of some of his averages.
Stats only tell part of the story, Brad. But as a coach, if you have a few players who can average double figures in multiple statistical categories, you're a lucky guy. Consistently, not win occasionally, but to win consistently. Winning consistently is one that stresses out a lot of coaching. Especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well, as well as score. Now you've got to give help on him and elite.
And a shot block. Three-point shooter spotting up. He shoots the jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper.
Free ones. He can't get one to fall.
the second shot. He may be in some trouble here. Pushes it up. There's the pick. There's the roll. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. Off the mark. Woodruff receives the pass. He attempts the jump shot. Knocks it down. When you notice a slasher, the defense has to be ready for your drive.
I tell you, he really has natural ability. Uses that athleticism to break down the defense. Really effective off the dribble.
The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
They're rocking right now, my goodness.
Tries for two. We continue to track the game's tempo.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Cross court. Takes his jumper. They got it.
Despite the foul.
At the line. He makes it.
Pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. He misses the J. He goes up with it. Missed it.
Spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Makes the shot. The Eagles might be in trouble here, Dick. It might be time to abandon any half-court sets and look at getting some baskets in transition.
Brad, it's definitely time to abandon their usual style and start playing an up-tempo game. They have no choice at this point.
The Hawks aren't strangers to playing in the half-court game, so at this point, they'll be able to continue playing their style, Dick, and ensure that that clock continues to wind down.
There's absolutely no need to take quick shots and be overly aggressive. They're in control right now and should remain in control.
Harden receives the pass. He puts up the J. And yet another missed field goal attempt.
They can't buy one, Brad. This is embarrassing.
Anderson handles the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. Puts up the J. Gets the J to fall. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. 9 on the shot clock. The center receives the pass. They just can't find the open seams on the floor.
They're struggling to score right now.
Douglas receives the pass. Trying to beat the buzzer.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
At the half.
Big City USA, baby, without question. Their shooting was absolutely atrocious, to put it mildly. They're going to have to do some serious regrouping in the locker room.
Side. A little effort. It almost looks like they got a lid on the goal, Dick. Nothing is falling for.
Wow, when a team is shooting a ball like this, I'm telling you, they're not focused. They're going to drive the coach bananas. Practice is going to be so tough tomorrow. I mean, they need repetition, repetition, repetition. And it's nothing but one brick after another. Get that good spacing.
Turn around jumper.
I'll tell you, what a nice turn around jump shot. Soft as velvet, getting away, passing the block.
They work the perimeter. Here comes the ball screen. Brewer receives the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Terrific shooting continues.
Hey, when you get in a funk like this, you've got to get a few gimmies, some layups, something that's going to get your rhythm back and give you the confidence to shoot from the perimeter.
For two, you betcha.
Pushes it up.
puts it up. Doesn't go. Bowen handles the feed. Cross court. Let's watch the move as he works his man. Fadeaway jumper. There's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
They look to get it to the inside. Three. He misses the fadeaway. Looking for a good shot. For two. These rims are giving them trouble, Dick. They can't get anything to drop.
Wow, when a team is shooting a ball like this, I'm telling you, they're not focused. They're going to drive the coach bananas. Practice is going to be so tough tomorrow. I mean, they need repetition, repetition, repetition. And it's nothing but one brick after another.
The perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He tries the jumper. Woodruff handles the feed. Trying to feed inside with the jumper. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Jumper, missed the jumper. Woodruff receives the pass. He goes up with it. Busts the J. Up the J. They're not doing a very good job of finding the hoop tonight, Dick.
Well, they're not working the ball around. They're not finding the open man.
Bowen receives the pass. Trying to feed the low block. Puts up the J. Knocks it down. Way out of. He blocks the shot. Working it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots kill chemistry, Brad.
On the elbow, they beat down the low block. Missed it. Bowen handles the feed. Trying to pack it inside. He shoots the jumper. The missed shot. The Eagles prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times, and then really settling in the half court at other times.
Definitely, Brad. They prefer a more balanced style, picking and choosing when to force the tempo and when to settle down in the half court.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Ware isn't the greatest free throw shooter.
He just needs to focus on the rim.
He sinks it. love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
The Eagles have been getting it done tonight in a lot of different ways.
Everyone is getting a foul, and everyone is having a good time. The great thing about basketball is you don't always have to score to be a threat. Teamwork can help you win a lot of games.
Receives the pass. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
And it's knocked loose. Around 8 minutes remaining. Into their zone motion now. Entry pass in the paint. Off the glass and no good. And they go into their motion offense, working with four.
I tell you, four around one makes it tough to defend a big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You better get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
Mullen is fired up right now emotionally.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you should be afraid to show your emotions.
He shoots from the corner. Jumper won't go. Mullen handles the pass. They work it around the perimeter. Here's the offensive drop step, a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
We're at the 7 minute mark. Ware handles the pass.